start by stating your name.
Karen Kemper Nicholson.
What was it like growing up in this area?
Okay. I didn't grow up in Aquasco. Mm-hmm. I spent summers in Aquasco. Okay. So I grew up in Washington, D.C. Okay. I went to school in D.C. When school was out every summer, the very next day we were sent, my sisters and I were sent to Aquasco to spend the whole summer up on the farm with my Aunt Marion, which was Marion Beatrice Adams. And we spent the whole summer there, every summer. And we would go to St. Dominic's Church or St. Michael's. We'd go back and forth. We would go to picnics at St. Dominic's. We would go to picnics at St. Peter's. We would go to Grimes' store every single day, 7 days a week. And during the summer, as I got older, I would sometimes have a job up at Orm Elementary School to work for the summer. We also, when they put in Baden Recreation Center, we used to go up to Baden Recreation Center to play.
Did she put you to work on the farm? Did you have to do any farm?
When we would come down in summer, I have a love for gardening, and it comes from her. Every summer, my job was up on Aquasco Farm Road. Her garden, her whole flower garden up there would be bricks. So my job every summer was to paint those bricks white. Okay, and then my job also was to go out and cut. She had roses all around there. And the prettiest one was a red and a yellow rose bush that they don't even have anymore because I have been trying to search them. The biggest yellow roses. And my job was to take the roses, cut them, put a little string around them, and make little bouquets. And then we would fill them up in a basket, and then we would go over to St. Peter's, to the original cemetery, because St. Peter's has two cemeteries. We would go to the first one and the second one and put flowers on all of the relatives.
Who was Papa Joe?
Papa Joe was Joseph Adams. That's where the Adams, what happened is there are seven Adams. We're coming off of Richard Adams, 1822 to 1886. What happened is the Adams came from England. And they left there and went to Fauquier County, Virginia.
Who were the Washington Senators?
That was a baseball team in Washington, D.C.
They're now the Nationals.
Yeah. Now it comes to the Nationals. It's a history as to how they changed. They started, the Banks Field, when Papa Joe had the field, what they had is they had teams of black baseball players. And the reason why I was interested was because when I went to do my research, there were no black books on blacks playing baseball. But I knew as a little girl, we had to do baseball every weekend. So Papa Joe had that land. He gave it to Aunt Nene. Well, it was given to Georgiana, who gave it to Aunt Nene. Okay, and the love of baseball continued. So Howard Folly Banks played for the Senators. And then before that, back in the day, Sharon has even pictures. I have them in one of our books of the team. Aquasco had their own team. Aquasco had their own team, just like Baden had their team, Brandywine had their team.
And this next question is about Papa Joe.
Joseph Adams.
Mm-hmm. Was he a tobacco farmer?
Yes, he was. They worked for themselves. And
That's where I was going.
Tobacco. So Aunt Marion never worked. Aunt Marion had tobacco, and Sharon's father, James, were her uncle, Walter Banks. They would all go and work on the farm for her.
So
that's Aquasco Farm.
Were they like basically?
And they would go to Upper Marlboro.
Trust, I guess you could say, is that where the financial backing was?
Well, it was through farming, through tobacco.
Right.
Uh huh. And also, I remember, because I'm younger than the first person that spoke, we would go, I remember, to Upper Marlboro, to the tobacco house to sell tobacco.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We would go down also for the summer, we would go down to Mirabelle's for crab cakes and slot machines.
Do you remember any musicians? I've heard about this place so much, but I haven't heard any.
I'm a little younger.
James
I went.
Brown.
Really?
James Brown would go there.
Domino.
And Fats Domino. And Fats Domino would also be, they would go to Can't Find It Bar. And so Fat Domino would be there.
Right.
And then also one of the Adams boys, Walter Adams, because Papa Joe had brothers and sisters. So one of his brothers had a family. And that family member was Walbur Adams. In fact, there are two or three homes now built in Aquasco that's made of stone. Walbur Adams did that. He did construction, and that was his trade. He did that, and it also, one time, he owned a bar there. I have people who remember that bar, but nobody can remember the exact name. His second wife was Inez. They lived in Aquasco. His repast was in Aquasco, but I don't know the name of that bar just yet. Mm-hmm.
So was there mention of Benedict because it was predominantly black previously?
What, for my family? The only thing I remember of Benedict is going to Mirabelle's for crab cakes and slot machines. That's the only thing I remember right now.
Going to where?
They call her Mirabelle's. It was Mirabelle's. And that's where you would go down to Benedict on the water. And she was famous for crab cakes. That was the crab cake of Maryland. And to play slot machines. That's what we did.
Yeah, my mother used to play with her daughter. So.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Those were black owned establishments.
That's where blacks went. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And they went to Moonlight Inn, Patsy and Gigi's, Can't Find It Bar, On Top, what is it, another one called On, the thing on top. They were all there. But those were all where the blacks went for entertainment. Cars Beach. Sparrow's Beach, Seagull Beach, and I remember on the radio every evening, Aunt Marion would have Hoppy Adams.